have certainly been getting our fair share of rainfall, so as we get ready for May flowers, we start this week's Explore Tulsa with Tulsa's fairest of old ladies.
Then doodads to remember you by.
Followed by a place for a perfect fit.
Plus medical supplies from the heart.
Hi, I'm Stevie Fernandez.
And I'm Trish Whitmer. We are very happy to see you back with us for this week's Explore Tulsa. Now, Stevie, have you seen many shows at the Brady Theater?
Oh my gosh, yes. The first show I saw was the Beatle Tribute Band 1964. Ooh. Then there was George Carlin and Alice Cooper and Weird Al, so many more.
The Brady has been around now for over 100 years, bringing Tulsa some of the finest in entertainment.
All the performers that have played there? In 100 years, someone should write a book about it.
Well, Jamie Townsend actually did. A very fun piece of Tulsa history from the perspective of the old lady of Brady.
When I learned that there was not a book available about the Brady Theater, this has been almost 20 years ago, and had started doing some research and looking through old newspapers, I felt like that the information needed to be collected, that our city needed to know the caliber of performers that have come and performed here over the years. You know, the origins of the Brady Theater really came from the early Tulsa Chamber of Commerce, and it was really the Tulsa Booster Club, and they wanted to have a center here in Tulsa where conventions could be held to compete with some of the other cities. The very first concert was here in October of 1914, and it was Madame Louise Homer from the New York Metropolitan Opera. So they went for a really large, you know, star at the time, and then probably one of the most famous of the earlier years would be Enrico Caruso back in 1920. There is the legend that Enrico still haunts the theater, and that has to do with the whole day that he spent here prior to his show that evening. He was taken out to be shown the oil fields by all the proud oilmen here in Tulsa, and all three of the vehicles broke down, and he ended up having to hitchhike a ride back on a cold October rainy evening to get back to the theater just before the curtain was to rise for the show. He died a little bit less than a year later of a lung-related type disease, and it was that he caught that pneumonia, that type of illness here in Tulsa, and so that's where that story comes from, that his ghost still haunts the theater to this day. This was known as one of his best performances here at the Brady Theater. The book covers a complete 100-year history of the theater and its early beginnings of how it was even voted into being and the early concerns and some of the earliest performers. One of my favorite parts was really just going in and finding out, you know, almost like an archaeologist on a dig, on a hunt, and finding the caliber of performers as I was coming across Mae West and Katharine Hepburn and W.C. Fields, and then all the you know, greater folks as time moved on, a Buddy Holly and all that, just uncovering those performances and then getting more details about what the show was like. The newspapers were written much more in depth at that time, so you can really get kind of a full story. I went through over 1,000 newsreels to go through section by section of the entertainment sections of the papers to find out who all had performed here and what conventions had been held here over the years. And just, I think my favorite story would be of John Jack, who actually grew up here in the theater. Up here, there was an apartment up on the upper level. His dad was the manager. He lived his whole life here until he went off to college. You know, grew up literally here in the theater as this being his home. And I think what a unique story that was. And in telling the story, it's called Memoirs of the Old Lady because I wrote it in the voice of the theater itself, of the old lady, even though that's just been a nickname that this theater's had since, in the 1930s were the earliest references I found to calling her the old lady of Brady. But I wrote it in her voice, telling her own story of her whole life history. And then it's intertwined with a lot of different interviews with various people involved, stagehands and managers, and of course, Peter Mayo and all the people involved with the theater. Probably if I could choose one show that I would have loved to have come to would be Nat King Cole. I love Nat King Cole. My dad always listened to him when I was growing up, and so to have been able to see him here would have just been incredible. We are so fortunate that Peter Mayo and his family have supported this theater over the years. It was literally set up to become a parking lot pretty much the moment the Performing Arts Center opened in 1977. So we are so fortunate to have one of Tulsa's historic jewels still alive and well, and you know, there's not a week that goes by that there's not, you know, shows here, and I'm so glad to see that he's carrying on the tradition here of the theater.
Oh my gosh, if those walls could talk. Buddy Holly, Will Rogers, W.C. Fields, Jamie's book is a great fun read.
If you're interested in getting a copy of Memoirs of the Old Lady, you can find the book at Dwelling Spaces, the Tulsa Historical Society, and Ziegler's Art and Frame, among other local bookstores.
Mm-hmm. That would make a great gift for just about every Tulsan. I wonder if you could have the Brady, though, made into like a salt and pepper shaker with our logo on it.
Not too sure about that, but the guy to ask would have to be the fun stuff king himself, Kevin Dean with Western Associates. We return with more Explore Tulsa.
Our most beautiful 4K HDR TV. Easily manage your cables for even a clean rear look. It hangs flat on the wall, just like a piece of art. Yet its slimness creates astounding images. Experience new discoveries with Android TV by getting instant access to everything you need. Introducing the latest Sony 4K HDR TV.
Hi, and thanks for sticking around with us for more Explore Tulsa.
Trish, you know what we need?
No, but I'm sure you're gonna let me know.
More stuff with Explore Tulsa logos on it, like a small version of our Tulsa bus with the ones on our pictures on it, and it could double as a flashlight.
Well, there is a place in town that makes all kinds of stuff just like that.
And the guy that makes all the more fun than ever has to be Kevin Dean at Western Associates.
I mean, I just love this business. I mean, it's just like Christmas every day. You know, you always got a new toy, new something coming out, get to try it, play with it, you know, and I just really enjoyed it. I have a friend, Pete Lumberg, who is in the business. He said, hey, you know, I think you would be good at this. And I coached his kids in soccer, and I said, you know, I have a window cleaning business, and I said, you know what, I'll give it a try. It's sort of cold in the winter. Well, Western Associates has been around for 60 years. It started in Marion, Kansas. Basically, they got into the promotional item business, and I promote myself as neat stuff. Well, you know what, we're always giving out neat stuff, so I'm sort of neat stuff, so let's do the neat stuff. So that's sort of how I got onto the neat stuff, and I just sort of took it and ran with it from there. I have fun. I mean, really. I mean, I'm sort of out there all. I've shown up at businesses, had these screaming monkeys that you could put your fingers in their paws and you could shoot them off across the room and they'd start screaming. And unfortunately, I did do that at one business and they were having a board meeting and they came out, you know, sort of they weren't too happy at the time until they realized it was me making the noise. And they said, oh, well, that's okay, it's Kevin. Because, you know, when I show up, basically their employees are having fun. And, you know, because if you're not having fun, why be in business? Oh, the big ties. I have these and I have the long ties. I like to stand out, be noticed. I mean, that's all about advertising. And if your business isn't being noticed, then why are you in business? You want to be noticed. And I wanted one and for Christmas and my daughter was trying to find one and we couldn't find one and my mom ended up making them. And it's sort of a staple. When people see me, they sort of expect to see the big tie. Well, for promotional items, really what you're trying to do is get your message out in front of them, get your name out in front of them, because for instance, TV, radio, newspapers, they're out in front of you for a little bit, but then they're gone. Promotional items stay out in front of you almost all the time. I mean, there's something you're using, there's something they're useful. That or is fun, like the screaming monkeys. I tend to go towards the fun stuff. But right now, selfie sticks are pretty hot. And the knockoffs of the Yeti tumblers are super hot. I mean, they are flying off the shelves. It's really amazing to see when something comes into our industry that's just so hot. We sell a lot of brand names like Swiss Army, Nike, Adidas, Under Armour. Under Armour is one of our specialties right now because we're one of the few companies in the country that was selected to be able to sell Under Armour to the promotional side. So that's really what promotional items are. When you give out something and you really enjoy, you know, handing it out, then people will, they get to see your name. And not just the people you gave it to, but the people that they show it to too. They go, if you give them, well, like we have hammers. Well, you needed a hammer for that, or you needed a light, you know, when your car was broke down to see, you know, change your tire or something. There's lots of different things. You might not need it now, but you might need it a little bit later, and it's always there, and your name is there. So if it's in, like, you know, you're changing the tire, you know, you're really in a pinch, it's just like, oh, wow, I'm glad I had this from Kevin, you know, or whoever it might be. So it's a pretty good deal.
People love those little tchotchkes. Anything free, always fun and memorable.
If you'd like to learn more about all the fun stuff Kevin Dean and his team have to offer, visit westernassociates.com.
Kevin could probably use some big shoes to go with those big ties.
Well, I don't know about big shoes, but with all the walking he does, having fun with clients, he definitely needs some really good shoes.
And in Tulsa, stylish shoes that are good for your feet can best be found at our next stop. Fleming Shoes is just ahead when we return with more Explore Tulsa.
John Erling with Voices of Oklahoma. Our great state has been home to countless individuals whose place in history has been earned through each of their many accomplishments. Voices of Oklahoma's mission is to preserve their story in an oral history presentation like none other. Accounts direct from famous Oklahomans, political figures, and many others who have left their indelible mark on the development, history, and future of Oklahoma. So please, treat yourself by listening to those who are the voices of Oklahoma.
Look at us. We woke up one morning with every song that ever mattered to anyone. So now what? Music's meant to be heard, out loud, where your life happens, where you dance, where you love, and where you live. When everyone has every song ever written, what matters most is how you listen.
Come here for yourself at Video Revolution.
If you're like me and your wife's shoes take up practically the whole closet, then you'll be so glad you stuck around for more Explore Tulsa.
A woman can never have enough pairs of shoes, BB.
See, for me, I just need a pair of shoes for whatever I'm doing. Working, running, or going out.
Three pairs of shoes. See, that's perfect. Leaves plenty of room for your wife to get more shoes. And the best place to find comfortable shoes that are good for your feet has to be Fleming's Shoes.
A lot of his friends thought he was a little nuts, because it was a big risk. Well, my dad worked in the oil business, bounced around all over the states doing that for a while. And when we had the oil drop in the mid-80s here in Tulsa, he kind of had to decide whether he wanted to move and he wanted to stay in Tulsa.
We had been talking about it quite a bit. He'd always wanted to start his own business. And so this was a great opportunity to do that.
We had a relative that had a shoe shop in Houston, and he spent about 6 months down there, kind of scouting out, and thought it'd be like a nice little niche to have a full service shoe store, to where it's kind of old school, sit down, consult with people, and provide like an excellent quality product with best service.
You know, when you work with your spouse, you have areas that you're really strong in, and they have areas that they're really strong in. And we kind of had a rule that when we got home, it would be home, you know, not business. Of course, we broke that rule a few times, but, you know, you have to have some boundaries.
Well, this was the daycare growing up, you know, during the summers.
Yes, we had three young sons that would run around the stacks in the back and play video games and, you know, that sort of thing. We tried to keep them as active as we possibly could.
Well, the foot's the foundation of the body. You know, we're all walking around on our feet, not our hands. And if your feet hurt, everything hurts. And everything starts from the feet. So a lot of the doctors that we work with, whether they're having foot pain, knee, hip, back, even up to the neck, you know, getting a good quality shoe that fits well and gives you proper support can help out your entire body.
As a podorthist, a lot of people aren't familiar with that term, but I'm licensed here in the state of Oklahoma to accept prescriptions from physicians and work with the medical, you know, professionals here in the town to provide, you know, good care. We, you know, oftentimes will fit people that have some braces or have some special needs. But then we do just fits for people walking in off the street too. So it is important, you know, like Ryan had said previously, we just have 2 feet that we have to take with us for the rest of our lives. And it's very important to get properly fitted and to kind of keep up with it. As we age, things change, our feet change, as well as other things. So it's good to actually come into a professional place like our facility, get your feet measured, and if there have been any changes, to reflect that, you know, in the footwear that we provide for them.
Well, it's interesting because I'm basically stepping on board as owner almost the exact same time when my dad opened the store. So it's kind of like passing the torch on, keep people comfortable in Tulsa, you know. So I mean, I feel honored to carry on, you know, our tradition of keeping things pretty simple, of carrying excellent product and providing superior service to consult people.
We have a very loyal clientele. You know, once someone comes in and we really fit them properly, their foot pain or maybe knee or hip pain goes away, they're usually our customers for life. And it's like a big family, really, because they'll bring in their brothers, their sisters, their husbands, their wives, you know, people that come in out of town. So we really are a family-oriented business here.
I love this about Explore Tulsa, meeting folks with family businesses that keep growing from one generation to the next.
To find out more about what Fleming's has to offer, visit FlemingsShoes.com.
I think it's great that they work with doctors all over town too, helping folks get the best shoes for their feet.
Well, in the U.S., we're very lucky to have all the medical options available to us.
It is easy to forget how good we have it. And thank goodness there are places like the Rotary Medical Supplies Network making it easy to let us all lend a hand to others too.
Next, we'll meet the founder of the Rotary Medical Supplies Network when we come back with more Explore Tulsa.
Hey, it's Stevie from Explore Tulsa with my friend and optometrist for many years, Dr. Robert Zellner. Tell everybody why it's so good to come in to see you.
Well, that's a great question. Let's see, we've got 2 great locations. We try to stay cutting edge at every point along the way because, let's face it, everybody wants to come in and get taken care of in a timely fashion and get the latest, greatest stuff and save some money and get on with their life and see clearly.
And if you don't believe it, look on the website.
Absolutely, drzellner.com. You can find that we have our 2 locations at 69th and Memorial and 3030 South Harvard, or you can give us a call at 749-2020 or 461-2020.
And I got 4 kids, and I gotta tell you, as a big family like that, it's affordable too.
Oh yes, and of course, the number one reason, you save some money. I mean, with our 2-pair specials, with our different unique packages that we put together, I mean, you can come in here and your money can go a lot farther than anywhere else.
And that's why, with Dr. Robert Zellner and Associates, seeing is believing.
Oh, I like that, yeah. Stevie. Well done.
For over 33 years, Video Revolution has been Tulsa's headquarters for all the best name brands of cutting-edge electronics. The experts at Video Revolution can put it all together for that ultimate home theater experience. Video Revolution on the northwest corner of 71st and Lewis for Tulsa's best team of qualified sales, service, and installation technicians.
Hello there. Thanks for stopping in for more Explore Tulsa. Now, each week, Trisha and I get emails from you telling us about interesting things going on around T-Town.
Or people who are just doing amazing things.
And we love to hear from you, too. So send us someone you'd like to see on the show to stevie@exploretulsa.com.
That's how we found the Rotary Medical Supplies Network, a group founded by Jack Maxwell, supplying people all over the world with donated medical supplies for free.
One of our mottos is service above self. So this is a service-oriented organization. This was something that I knew that I could help other people with.
I was in the Philippines recruiting physical therapists for a company that I had at the time by the name of Maxwell Healthcare. So I went over and was recruiting up in Angeles City, up by Clark Air Force Base. And I was asked by the owners of the hospital and college there to please go and talk to Tony Anglis's Rotary Club tomorrow. He doesn't have a speaker. Just tell the people what you're going to do with the PTs. So I did that, and after that talk, I was begged for equipment. And I told the people that I couldn't promise them that I could do that, but I would promise them that I would try. That was in January of 1996, that we shipped our first 4C containers to the Philippines and got it there. So we were extremely happy. It shut up all the naysayers that say you can't. But success comes in cans, not cannots. And every time somebody told me you can't do something and I thought I could, I just tell them to hide in the bushes and watch.
When Jack Maxwell first came to my club, the Rotary Club of Tulsa Sunrise, and was talking about this, and I said, you know, I see a lot of things out there. This is one thing that I can get involved in and help a lot of people, not only locally, but internationally.
And it was so impressive in the district that the district decided they wanted this as a district project, not just a local project, which was started by the Tulsa Rotary Club when I was a member of their club.
To make this warehouse work, we need three things. We need one, volunteers, organizations, churches, youth groups that want to come in and work in the warehouse, volunteer their time, do an inventory, helping to maintain the warehouse. The second thing is sponsors. I call a sponsor someone who has connections in a foreign country, who would like to be able to send a container to a foreign country and can afford to pay for that because we don't pay for shipping. And the third thing is we need donations. Not only monetary donations, which we're looking for foundations that would like to be able to put us on their annual donation list, we're also looking for equipment and supplies donations. Someone has a relative who transitions on. They end up with a bed, a lot of medical supplies left over. What do they do with it? They can call us up, donate it to us. We're a 501c3, so they get a tax write-off on that. A lot of the institutions are very helpful. St. Francis, St. John's, Hillcrest, Medical Centers, Cancer Treatment Center, Tulsa Bone and Joint. They're all big supporters and they will give a lot of things to us. I've had dialysis machines given to me a week after they were taken off service just because they bought brand new ones. It's amazing how many lives have been saved and bettered just because they were able to get hold of something that somebody here in the States couldn't use anymore. Or we get a lot of new stuff and we'll send brand new stuff over there. And it's amazing how many lives that we can save.
I mean, I feel so blessed and so helped because so many Rotarians stepped up and shared their talents with us. But I'll tell you, I am the godfather of it, and I will support it till the Lord calls me.
Jack and VJ have been doing wonderful work. That warehouse was full of so much medical supplies from generous doctors and individuals who just want to help others.
If you'd like to learn how you can help the Rotary Medical Supplies Network with a donation of materials or as a financial donor,
they also have a cool fundraiser selling tickets in a raffle for a brand new 2017 Mercedes.
Ooh, yep, that too. Visit msni.org to learn more.
I tried to talk them into giving me one of those dental chairs for my living room.
I don't even want to know why would you want that, but if you have a need for anything for your family, there's a good chance they'd be able to help you out.
My teeth always feel so mini fresh in a dental chair.
Stick around, there's more Explore Tulsa just ahead.
Like parents have a thing, when it gets too quiet in the home, we're worried, you know what I mean? I don't like silence in the home because it just feels dead.
Silence, that just doesn't feel like a creative place to me.
Turning on music in your house is almost like turning on the lights in your house.
Music makes mundane stuff better. And it's never too late to discover new things.
You just never know what song's gonna come on next.
Silence is probably the enemy of a happy home.
Come here for yourself at Video Revolution.
Hi, Dr. Robert Zellner here. For over 20 years, I've offered affordable, convenient eye care in Tulsa. Right now, you can get one pair of glasses or contact lenses starting at just $99 or my two-pair deal for $129. Hey, and as always, the eye exam's included. Walk-ins are always welcome. Glasses are ready in about an hour. Plus, we have over 2,000 frames to choose from. We're open 7 days a week. Come see why we're voted Tulsa's best. And our drive-thru at 69th and Memorial makes pickup simple and easy. For the best eye care value in Tulsa, Dr. Robert Zellner and Associates.
Have you outgrown your home entertainment system? Then it's time to step up with Video Revolution and Sony for the ultimate 4K home theater experience. Size does matter when it comes to the quality and enjoyment that you get from a home entertainment system. Engineered by the experts at Video Revolution on the northwest corner of 71st and Lewis.
Be sure and join us next week when we meet Russ Knight at the Christian Brothers Automotive in Tulsa Hills.
Special thanks to Jamie Townsend for all the hard work you did on writing the memoirs of the old lady.
Thanks too to Kevin Dean and the folks at Western Associate for bringing us fun stuff. And thanks to Ryan and Angela Fleming for giving Tulsa Feet a break at Fleming's Footwear.
Also thanks to Jack Maxwell and VJ Lively for all the great work you're doing at the Rotary Medical Supplies Network.
Remember, if you miss any of the show, you can always catch us at ExploreTulsa.com.
As always, each week we feature the people, places, and attractions that make us proud to call Tulsa our home.
Hey, don't forget to like us on Facebook. Share with us someone you think Tulsa should know more about.
Plus, remember, Explore Tulsa is brought to you by Video Revolution, located on the northwest corner of 71st and Lewis.
Stop by, say hello to Ron and all the guys for all your home entertainment needs.
And Explore Tulsa is also proudly brought to you by Dr. Robert Zollner and Associates.
Home of the two-pair deals, starting at just $99 with two locations, 3030 South Harvard and 69th and Memorial.
Well, that's all the time we have for you on this week's show, but we'll see you next week right here on Explore Tulsa.